welcome, Pisces. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you, Pisces. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. It's a good year, Pisces. You have the energy of the Emperor. Energy of the Emperor is here. The sun is shining. So, Pisces, let's see what's coming up for you guys in this year. This reading is from the 24th. 1st of March, okay? So it is from the 24th to the 1st of March. So I want to say to you guys, thank you for being here. Let's see what is going to be happening for you, Pisces. So we see the energy of the Hermit for the people who are born on the 24th, people who are born on the 25th. I see secrets. The High Priestess is here, so that is going to be good. The people who were born on the 26th, I see a Tower moment. So something is going to be living your life. People who were born on the 27th, I see the energy of the Star. People who were born on the 28th, you have the Wheel of Fortune. And people who were born on the 29th, I see the energy of the Devil, secrets. And the people who were born on the 1st, you're going to be having a brand new start. So, Pisces. And then you have a cycle ending. So this... You have a cycle ending. You have a fire sign and a hurt sign that is going to be carrying you through this year. This year is going to be a wonderful, positive year because there is so much positive energies that is coming up. Things are leaving your life. Secrets are coming out. Healing are going to be happening. The Wheel of Fortune is going to bring positive alignment of energies. So you're in a fire year. And when you're in a fire year, what happens and what transpire with a fire year is you clear up issues and situations. So if you were having like issues and situation in the past, you're going to be clearing that up now in the future. Okay, so this year it's going to be all about you clearing up things, situation that was transpiring. Okay. So, each and every one of these energy is going to affect you guys. So, if you're having your birthdays, and happy birthdays to the people who are having leap year. It's your every 4 years you have birthdays. So, this is going to be a wonderful year. However, this is going to play out for you. It's going to be good because I see a lot of you, especially business people, I see things are going to be happening. Ends is coming to secrets and people around you. The ends is coming to secrets and people around you. However that is transpiring, I see the ends that is coming up with people and secrets around you guys. So we're first going to be looking at the person who was born on the 24th. You have the energy of the Hermit. You have the scene and coming out of the hardship with an Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius, okay? So, however this was coming up in your life is that some of you were dealing with an Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius that has placed you in some hardship. And now, what I see is that the truth is coming out for you guys, okay? The truth is coming out. So, it's as if you people, you're going to be moving forward. You're going to be moving out of hardship. So if you were born on the 24th and you had some hardship you were dealing with, you are going to be definitely moving out of this hardship, okay? So let's see what else is coming up for the Pisces on the 24th, because you're seeing the deceptiveness, okay? So what has happened is that the deceptiveness of someone you were dealing with, who could be an Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius, the truth. It's as if you are going to be bringing the truth of the lies and the deceptiveness of someone that was deceiving you for quite some time. You show them up. It's as if you are going to be seeing the deceptiveness that was at play. So you are going to be showing up some deceptiveness, some issue and some situation that someone, and this could be a Taurus and an Aries, could have brought you in some issues, okay? Because this is hardship. This is hardship and moving out of the hardship for some of you. So it could be that a Taurus and an Aries have brought you in some hardship, and you are showing up these people, the lies and deceptiveness of these people. So however it is transpiring, I see you find out what has transpired and you see the truth, and you're showing up the truth to what has transpired and what has happened. So you're shedding light, okay? The Hermit is going to help you to shed light on things, a theft that has transpired with a Taurus, and this is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, but this is definitely a Taurus, okay? So there is a lot, you're shedding light on a lot of stuff. You're coming out of hardship. You're moving out of the hardship in this year, and it's going to be wonderful and positive. So you have the energy of 9, you have the energy of 5, and you have the energy of twice 5. So changes is going to be happening. And you have the energy of 23. 23 is 5 again, so 55. So you have 9 and 55. Whatever the issue and the situation is, I see you're going to be showing up people for the deceptiveness that they have done in your life, okay? Okay. So we're moving forward to the people who were born on the 25th. I see you have the energy of secrets coming out. So if you were born on the 25th, you're going to be finding out something about your family or your partner. However this is coming up, is it the family, is it the partner, you're going to be finding out something, because information is going to be coming out, and you're going to be finding out that your partner or your families have not told you the truth, okay? I see your burden is going to be over, because I see that someone, it could be your partner or family members, your mother or father, is going to be coming in and helping you out to move you out of a deceptive play, a deceptive situation, and a deceptive play that has transpired. So this is very good, because inner wisdom is going to be coming in. Inner wisdom, inner understanding is going to be coming in for the people who are born on the 25th. This year is as if you're going in your mode of being the authority in your own life, and you're bringing things to a circle, to an end. You're bringing cycles to an end, and this is very good, because what this is doing is that it is bringing out and showing up the deceptiveness that was at play, okay? I see a lot of communication, so positive communication could be coming in for you guys. You have shown up something that people were not aware of. You're bringing in the wisdom, and you're communicating, and you're going to be getting a lot of recognition for something that you have done. So 25th, people who were born on the 25th, this is looking good, because I see you and your partner, or you and your parents, or you and your family member is going to be bringing out things that was not, but positive recognition is going to be coming to you, people who were born on the 25th, okay? Could be from family members or people in your family, but I see you're opening up doors of opportunities. I see you're going to be coming out of a hardship, and I see positive recognition is coming out. So what we're seeing here is that we are seeing the energy of secrets coming out, and information is definitely coming out. I see this is going to be positive because I see your partner and people around you and your family is going to be protecting you. And this is definitely going to be good. So for you people who were born on the 25th, you have 2, you have 6, the energy of the lover. Some of you could be getting married or moving in together. That is going to be releasing your burdens. So that is definitely going to be good. and I see positive recognition and people in your life and people around you is going to be showing up for you, okay? And this is going to be good. So you have 2, 6, 10, and 12. You're working with 3, you're working with 0, you're working with 1, okay? So we're moving on to the people who were born on the 6th, the 26th. The tower moment is here. The people who were born on the 26th, I see a tower moment here. A huge tower moment for a young person. A huge tower moment could be coming up for a family member. You could be losing a family member. And a tower moment is here for an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. Whoever these two people are in your life, this is coming up as a father figure. This is coming up as a partner. The younger person is coming up as a child or someone, a cousin, a relative, a sister, a brother. But there is the tower moment that is coming up for these people. Whatever that these people have done, the truth is coming out in this year. So it's as if you guys have the authority and the information and bringing out something. Now, these two people are going to be finally removed from your life. Now, this is the tower is people and situation moving from your life. Now, these two person, it could be a father figure and a child. It could be people on the work floor. It could be a boss. It could be a deceptive businessman and deceptive things that was happening and transpiring around you. Now, however this is coming up, this is about these people and these situation. So some of you are going to be standing your ground using the energy of this passion in order to remove people and situation that has been creating havoc in your life. And you're standing your ground and as if you are saying no more. And because you move in these two person, you are going to be bringing in long-term stability in your world because people are going to be finding out whatever deceptiveness and whatever that was playing, the deceptiveness that was transpiring. So this is good because this is about long-term stability, okay? It is about long-term stability. So you or who are born on the 26th is kind of standing your ground, standing in your world and saying no to something. You're definitely saying a no. This is over. This has gone in, far enough and this is over. So you're moving out these people in order to bring long-term stability, okay? You're clearing up things, situation in order to bring long-term stability in your world, okay? So this is powerful. This is really powerful. This is a wonderful, powerful situation that is going to be transpiring. Then as we look at the people who were born on the 27th, we see the energy of the stars. So this is powerful. For the people who were born on the 26th, you have 16, 7, and 33. 16, 7, and 33. Those are the energy that you're going to be working on. 16 is the day. 7 is the hours, or 7 or 16 is the day or hours. You can use these numbers as you go through the year to use them to work with. I see success is here for the people who were born on the 27th. Whatever is transpiring, I see success is coming in your world. I see you're making changes and successful changes is going to be coming in your world. Now, with this success, I see you're going to be leaving a situation behind and moving forward because you finally ended some deceptive situation that was going on. You finally ended this and you're moving forward. You're moving away from your enemies and leaving your enemies behind because of some deceptive play. You found out who these deceptive people were and what they have done, okay? And the situation, because these are people that was working against you and you stood your ground. You overcome a situation and you're going to be overcoming a situation and you're going to be moving forward. This is going to be wonderful and very positive because there were people who were really using their power and you have left them behind. You have decided this is not working and you're leaving them behind. as you decided that, you end the deceptiveness that was transpiring. You see your enemies and you are going to be cutting them down, cutting them off. So for the people who were born on the 27th, this is a year where you're seeing people who were working against you and you stood up and you're really cutting them down and cutting them off. It's a very successful year for you. You're going to be moving forward in the right direction. You're leaving people and situations that no longer serving you, and you stood your ground. You really, really stood your ground. So this year is a year where you people who were born on the 27th is turning your backs on your enemies, and you're making a shortcut. You're making a shortcut. You're moving people, cutting away things and situation. If you have to deal with surgery and that sort of a thing in this year, you're going to be healed. Okay, so it's going to be good. So you have the energy of the moon, which is the star, which is 17. 17 is 8. So money, unexpected money, is going to be coming in. Then you have the energy of the 18. 18 is the energy of the moon, which is 9. So you have 18 and 9. You have 17 and 8. Then you have 6. And then you have 11. So a lot of good positive situations is going to be happening. 10. You have 10. So you're using this sword. You're using the size to cut away things that no longer serve you. And this is going to be good. And then you are taking a new move. So congratulations to you guys. As we look at the people who were born on the 28th. So this is 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. The people who were born on the 28th, you have the Wheel of Fortune. This is a beautiful, beautiful energy, because some of you have been going through issues, situation that was affecting your life, and you're bringing this away. The Wheel of Fortune is coming in, and it's coming in very good. You guys are going to be lucky. So if you were born on the 28th of February, you're going to be lucky this year. News is coming in, and you are going to be finding out that you're moving out of a cycle in under positive cycle. And this cycle is positive. News is going to be coming in. It's going to be bringing you a lot of luck and a lot of money. So this is good. This is positive. Positive alignments of energy. Truths are coming out. Whatever the deceptiveness that was plain, I see truths coming out for you guys. It's a wonderful year that is coming up for you guys, because the Wheel of Fortune is going to bring in you in a lot of money. Some of you, if you wanted to get pregnant, could be getting pregnant, and you'll have the money to financial support your family. So I see the Wheel of Fortune is bringing a financial abundancy for you and your family. 10 of Pentacles, this is good. So it's going to be a very, very wonderful year for you guys that was born on the 28th, because whenever the Wheel of Fortune comes in and it's bringing you such positive news, it's all about making the money this year for you people. 28 is 10 Wheel of Fortune. Okay, so you're always lucky. You're one of these people that is lucky and is not aware of it. And this is showing you up, because 2 and 8 is 10. You have the Wheel of Fortune, which is 10, and you have the 10 of Pentacles. You're going to have a lot of luck in this year, especially when it comes up to money. Okay, so sometimes we're not aware of this. So news is going to be coming in. Some of you could be also receiving unexpected fortune that is coming in. And I see a friend is going to be helping you out. I see you're going to be connecting with a friend. Whatever you do with a friend, whatever you build as a company in this year with a friend, is going to make you a lot of money. Okay, so if you're going to be working with friends or soul family, because friends are basically soul family, you're going to be creating a lot of money. And I see news is going to be coming in, letting you know. Some of you could be finding out that a friend have left you a lot of money that you weren't aware of. And this is going to be good. So wonderful, positive energy. I see a friend is going to be really letting you know that there is some money that you were supposed to receive. Okay. So we're moving forward. Let's move forward and see what else is coming out for the people who are born on the 29th. I see you're dealing with the moon. These are people that was lurking. These are energies, but you're very safe, okay? So you're dealing with the energy of the moon. This is a water energy, so this is good. And what this is teaching you is that your spirit guides is watching over you and protecting you. The moon is very far. All your enemies is trying to reach you, but they can't reach you. And I think this is something that you're going to be teaching yourself, how to protect yourself from people and situation that doesn't serve you anymore. And this is going to be very good because it's going to be aligning you in positive alignment of energy where it's bringing you in really wonderful energies and situation that is going to be coming up for you. And this is going to be good. So in this year, you're going to be protecting yourself and showing up for yourself. You're going to be standing up against people. This is going to be good because you're going to be victoriously overcoming issues and situations that with people that was working against you. You are seeing the truth. You're going to be moving forward. You're going to be standing up above your enemies. You're going to be overcoming your enemies, overcoming the people and situation that was trying to block you and keep you from what it is that you were supposed to be received. So if you notice, you're standing, there is the energy of the moon, and these are people and situation that was trying to hold you back. You can look how beautiful this is, because this is you. This is you. These are the people and situation that tried to hold you down, hold you back, keep you from the abundance that was coming in your life. And I see now you finally have the move to move forward. You're standing your grounds. You're going to be moving forward, whether or not people, because these people have been holding you back for quite some time. And now you're taking the rein in your hands and you're moving forward. And your wishes and dreams is going to be coming true. So people who were born on the 29th, congratulations. Really, congratulations, ladies and gentlemen, because what is happening and what is transpiring is that you are taking the rein in your end and you're moving forward and you're really going to be very successful. Your wishes and dreams are going to be coming true because you victoriously come out of a situation that you were dealing with. So the whole year is that you are just going to be moving forward. No matter whatever obstacles that comes up in your life, you're going to be just taking the rein and moving forward. Your wishes and dreams, anything that you had wish and hope for, yes, it is going to be given to you because this situation that was holding you back is now leaving you, and you're moving forward, you're galloping forward, you're taking your reign and you're making your world and your wishes and dreams coming true. Okay, so you have 18, which is 9, you have 7, and you have another 9. So 18, so 9, you're ending cycles. It is the center of this year for the solar year for you guys, is that you're ending cycles in your world. And look at this, isn't this beautiful? Because you're coming out. So beautiful, beautiful energies, transition, things are ending, you're ending things, ending the energy of your enemies that has been working against you and blocking you. You stand your ground, the energy come of transformation, where you're ending the deceptiveness and the people were working against you, and you're removing them and you're moving forward, releasing yourself from deceptiveness, and a transition is coming in. The transition that is coming in is a very positive transition, okay? So what is happening and transpiring? You have 18, 9, 9, 7, and 8, because this is an 8. So there is unexpected money. Your financial world is going to be changing, but it's going to be very positive. So wonderful. Let's move on and see what is coming up for the people who were born on the 1st of March. Congratulations again for the people who were born on the 1st of March. This is a positive energy of you moving forward. If you want to start a business in this year, you can start a business. This business is going to be moving you to a higher level. Changes, you're making changes in your life, you're moving forward, and this is going to be good. It's as if it's a yes, go ahead. Whatever changes you're going to be doing after your birthday until your next birthday, go ahead and do it. An offer is going to be coming in. So if you're looking for work, if you're looking for a business partner, if you want to connect with people, situation, organization, institute, say, if you were hoping to work someplace, if you were hoping to start your business or connect with another group, or an offer is definitely coming in. Okay, an offer is definitely coming in. Some of you are going to be, it's hard for you to leave something behind, but I see you're going to be taking this offer because this offer is going to take you a long place, okay? I see some of you, an offer could be coming in. It's not really what you want, but I see you're going to be taking it anyway, moving with it, okay? So it's not really what you want, this offer, but take it anyway. I see this offer is coming in from your parents for some of you, and for some of you is a new promotion. Maybe it's not paying much, but take it because you can create an opportunities for yourself. So a lot of you are going to be receiving new offers. It is not really what you want, but it's going to be a management position. Some of you, your parents are going to be coming in and helping you and offering you to come back home, or offering you to help you. Maybe they're giving you something that you don't want, but take it because you can use it and use it to open up doors of opportunities. Some of you could become parents. This is definitely that some of you could become parents. You might have problems with your pregnancy, but it's going to be okay. So wonderful, wonderful alignment from energies. With this new start is coming up, and an offer is coming in. It's not really well paid, but it is a management offer. And that is what is good. It's not really well paid, but it's a management offer. And I see the people in power could be offering you something. It's not what you wanted, but I see that they could be offering you something. So however this is coming up. But I see a lot of you are going to be getting pregnant, but there is going to be some problems with your pregnancy. Don't give up, okay? Just don't give up, because the situation that is transpiring, you're going to be making changes in your life, okay? So whatever you're getting and whatever you're receiving, I see some of you are thinking, yeah, I deserve better than this, okay? However, that is going to be coming up and transpiring, okay? I was just thinking about what to use, and before I start my readings, I always ask who wants to come out. So because you guys are working with the unseen world, the Ascendance Masters is going to be coming in to give the message for you guys, okay? Definitely. So come out of the closet. So you guys receive the energy of come out of the closet. Whatever is happening, whatever is transpiring, be who you are. Just accept who you are and be who you are. Come out, be awakened to the things and situation that is transpiring. And you're going to be receiving a lot of help. A lot of situation is going to be happening for you. Don't try to gain love by being someone else's slave. Remember that you matter too. Okay, so sometimes we love someone so much that we want to become their slave. And this is why they're saying, come out of the closet. Do not be someone else's slave. Know that you are, you need to love yourself. When you love yourself, when you get out of the closet and love yourself, you will understand that people will love you too and have respect for you. Okay? Because this is a time when a lot of people needs to take back their power. A lot of people need to take back their power. Okay, you don't have to gain love from someone by being their slave. You just need to take back your power and be who you want to be. Okay, life is about people respecting you and standing up. Namaste.